on this very same channel a few years back. I was torturing the owner of this channel. But now, I think it's time that you, the viewer, and I play a wicked game. Like a voyeur, behind the comfort of your computer, writing ugly ass comments. Think it's going to make you more creative, likable, interesting, fun, laughing at your own evilness. What do voyeurs see when they look into the mirror? Let's find out. Right now, you're being watched. And if for 1 second you forget you're being watched, you lose. Your only way out is to find the meaning of life and stop trolling people on the internet. Remember, knowledge is power. And I don't know, can't really do anything through the internet, but I'll be watching.
Hello, my Smashing Beauties, and welcome back to SmashingBeauty.com or Smashing Beauty on YouTube. And if you follow me on my YouTube channel, and if you go under the community section, from time to time I ask you guys what kind of videos would you like to see. So I have pre-recorded some videos while I'm talking about this video, and a few of you actually wanted to see some special effects and Halloween related videos, because as you know, this channel was very famous for these kind of topics. However, since YouTube changed their policies, making Halloween and special effects related videos, there's kind of like a ban on it, because as you see, I don't really make that many anymore, because YouTube is like, no, we don't want anything, you know, like not PG and family related. So I'm gonna try to change a few of these rules, because I've recently watched Eliot Roth's kind of documentary about horror movies and what the purpose of them is, and I think I found an answer on how to stick to the PG rating so it's appropriate for everyone. So it's under the age of 17, so that it's 17 and below, or that anyone from 14 and up can watch it. So, I'm not going to be making a video like that today. However, today I'm going to be doing a puppet. I think you guys already know based on the title. However, as you guys might know, Billy the Puppet is from Jigsaw, and it's one of my favorite characters. And it's one of actually my... You can see a link somewhere here. It's one of the videos which actually got me noticed on YouTube, and I kind of made a little sketch out of it. And if you watch my intro, I have made a new sketch, and hopefully you do like it. So this is going to be... This should be actually at the end of the video what I'm talking about. Or it's going to be for the makeup. I don't know. Make sure to check the info box below so you can skip through this if you're kind of like, I don't want to know behind the scenes kind of thing. So today we're going to be doing this. I'm just going to be doing... Maybe I'll be doing an over voice. I don't know how I'm going to do this. When I start doing the makeup, I'll see. I'm going to be showing what I'm going to be using, but I'm going to tell you off the bat. I'm using liquid latex. I'm using spear gum. I'm using cotton balls, I'm using tissues, I'm using various face paint, right? And that's about it. I am not going to be using fake blood, because I would like all of this to stay PG rated. So yeah, that's about that. All right guys, so let's get down to business. Excuse my look, because there's a few things I'm going to be doing, and so I don't really want to, like, you know, look pretty while I'm doing this. So I'm going to quickly tell you what I'm doing. So the first thing I want to do is I want to take some spear gum. Hopefully this one still kind of works. And I am going to glue some round cotton balls on my cheeks. Self-explanatory. So let's go do that. Okay, so I found the best solution is to make my nose really crooked. As you can see, this sponge does the job. So I'm actually gonna cut the sponge in half, and actually less than a half. I'm gonna make it a little bit smaller, and I'm going to be using it. Let me see. And I'm just gonna make it a little bit shorter, actually thinner. I'm gonna cut it by length like that. So this is an old sponge. That's it. Perfect. It's gonna give me that nice little crooked sense. Let me see. Yeah, that's it. Great. So I'm gonna apply that, and one more thing I'm gonna show you. This is a bald cap, right? And I'm not gonna be applying a bald cap because my forehead is quite high as is. So I am going to try to use this in order to kind of get like a smoother surface instead of using maybe tissue. I'm gonna see what works best. So. And then I'm gonna apply latex over that tissue, so I'm just to make that thing. The good thing about this doll is that it doesn't have any smooth surface. It's kind of like a rough surface doll if you look at it. And I will put a link in the description box below to an actual picture of an authentic doll from the creator. So after we've done all this, I used a fan to help dry faster. Then you can basically see where you didn't apply liquid latex. So I'm gonna apply some setting powder on my hand. And what you wanna do is you wanna apply this everywhere where you had the liquid latex. And of course, you know why, you don't want it to adhere. You want the liquid latex to adhere to something and you want it to be your powder. So the next step is applying white face paint. I'm going to be applying it everywhere besides my eyes and apply 2, 3, 4 layers. It doesn't matter. Just make sure that you kind of let it dry in between. All right, so the next thing is I'm going to be taking a contouring shade. This is specifically for my eyes. And I'm going to be doing shadows around certain areas. And then later on, I'm gonna go over with it with black so it's not so flat as is. Thank you.
you've been wondering when I was gonna show up on this channel again? Well, I'm back. I'm back and we're time to play a new game. You got some time? I think you do. You know you're enjoying.